I am Dr. Srikar, consultant pulmonologist, critical care and sleep medicine specialist at Apollo Hospital, Jubilee Hills. So the term COVID-19, this causes a stir in our mind. So we know a lot more than what we know way back in December 2019 when it first struck us. So what happens to these people who have recovered from COVID-19? So the most common complications which we are observing in these people are the vague symptoms. Some of them come to us back, they revisit the OPD saying that I am having some sort of a fatigue, I am not able to carry out my day-to-day activities. And a good number of them come back saying that I am having this persistent cough. Though I had this cough during COVID, I am still suffering from it. So how do we approach this cough? We need to differentiate between the cough caused due to some other additional secondary infection, as we call it, after a recovery from COVID, versus what actually persists or lingers on after recovery from COVID, the non-infective counterpart, which we otherwise called as long COVID or the post-COVID state. So if we are very sure that the cough is just mild, it is just, you know, lingering for a certain period of time, we can instruct the patient to take some basic antitussive medication. We can prescribe it for a short duration of time and assure him that it's going to settle down in a short period of time. We can suggest some simple breathing exercises, deep breathing exercises, basic physiotherapy and active mobilization, along with adequate hydration. Now the second tricky part is when the patient might be suffering from a secondary, either a bacterial or a fungal infection, which can also cause cough. So if the patient is having phlegm, or what we medically call as expectoration, that is when we need to investigate further. We need to probably get the phlegm sample for analysis, rule out an infective cause, and then treat accordingly. The other more common complaint which we see is breathlessness. Now this term breathlessness, once the patient has recovered from COVID, is a little tricky because it could mean deconditioning, that is the patient is lying immobile or barely moving from 14 days at least during the period of quarantine, or if he's admitted in an ICU or in the hospital. So after 14 days of rest, if the person suddenly starts walking, even if it was a very healthy person, he's definitely going to feel a bit breathless. This in contrast to the post-COVID breathlessness because of residual lung scarring or a secondary infection. So these two entities are what we need to differentiate. So if the person is having breathlessness secondary to deconditioning, we just need to, you know, check out preliminary. We ask him to monitor his saturation levels. If the saturation levels are good, make him walk around for at least 6 minutes at a brisk pace, as we call a 6 minute walk test. If the saturation levels are the same or they've improved further, well and good. If the saturation levels are dropped, we need to investigate further. What are the further investigations we go for? We would like to first get a cardiac evaluation done because post-COVID symptoms can also affect the heart. So we need to get an ECG and a 2D echo done and send him to the cardiologist for a review. And if that turns out to be normal, then if we still have a clinical suspicion, we can go for a lung function test or a pulmonary function test. And we can also get a imaging study done. This could be a simple chest x-ray. If we are able to make out something from it, well and good. If at all we still have a further suspicion, we can go for a high resolution CT scan or the HRCT, wherein we can correlate the previous clinical picture of the patient with the current one and come to a conclusion. Thank you.